guys, it's Model Horse Love. Long time no see, I know. I was in college, so, you know, wasn't really here, but right now I have some time to film some videos, so, yeah, let's get started. This video might be a little long, so maybe grab a snack. We're gonna be doing a massive Breyer haul. So, this is collective since, like, November. I think I have 8 traditional models, some classics, and some stablemates. I also did buy 2 resins, and then, I bought another horse. I'm not gonna include those in the video just because, well, the Breyer I actually already had and then I sold it and then I regretted selling it and so I bought another. And then the 2 resins, they're unpainted and I'll show them in another video. So yeah, right now I just wanted to focus on like Breyers, and these are all like kind of Breyers that I got straight from Breyer or straight from like a dealer for the most part. So I figured it would just all fit together to do kind of this kind of, like, to do a video of them all together. I didn't want to include the resins because it would be pretty long. So yeah, without further ado, let's get started with the haul. I was in the Stablemate Club for 2019. So yeah, the only ones I ended up keeping were the, I got a glossy Fiero on the Murata mold, and then I got my Iris, who's the Silver Bay. And then the last one is Corbin, I think. Corbin. So yeah, he's on this new Irish drop mold. I am really excited about this guy. This is like probably one of my favorite new stablemate molds. I'm really loving the new molds they're coming out with. So yeah, I'm gonna take him out of box. There he is. I'll take him out of here. So yeah, this is one of my, like, probably maybe my favorite release of the year. Oh my god, he's so cute. There he is. Oh my goodness. Oh, he has Breyer. Like, he has a Breyer stamp on his belly. He's so cute. Oh my goodness. This is, like, probably my new favorite stablemate. Well, one of my favorites, at least. He's cute as can be. I love his little mane. So, super cute. Really happy to have him. I'm pleasantly surprised by this guy. I had him in box for a while, so I knew what he looked like, but obviously having him out of box is quite different. This is such a nice mold. Oh my god. Kind of reminds me of the Peterstone Pebbles or Chip Warm Blood. So next I did the Collectors Club Appreciation. So I'm gonna show you what I got for that. I actually ended up doing 2 rounds. I did the first round, and then since I bought a second account for like next year, but I did it on a different email, just because I use that one more. And so I was able to actually do the round for like the one that's coming in May. So I'll show you the horses I got for that too. But the first round I got the stablemate. I was hoping to get the gold charm, but I just got the regular Palomino, but that's okay. This is my first one on the molds. I mean, I can still show it on this side, so I'm not, can't really complain. It's cute. Here's the rub on it above his eye, but I mean, I'm not really complaining, so yeah. Alrighty, moving on. So next I got the Mighty Muscle Draft. I adore this mold. Like, I definitely like it more in person. I am selling mine because he has this on his hip. So if anyone like just wants a shelf piece or play model or like to customize, then they can have it because I really wanted one that I could show. So I'm just gonna probably end up like for the Collectors Club Appreciation next year just buying another one of these because that's where I buy any like regular runs that I get. I don't buy regular runs throughout the year. My camera died, so if it looks darker, it's because it is darker outside because it's later in the evening. I think I left off, I was showing you guys the Mighty Muscle Draft and that he's for sale, and I will be getting another one most likely that's in better condition. I guess next I'll show you the other horse I got, Malik, who's the horse of the year from 2019. Actually disappointed in this guy as well because I noticed he has rubs on his face. I mean, it's hard to see in the box, but I love the mold, so hopefully I might buy another one, or maybe when I go to a show, hope I have the luck to win one if it's like in a silent auction or a raffle. But yeah, I might get him customized or customize him myself, or I might sell him. This mold is gorgeous. I love Sarah Mink. I only have 2 of her sculpts. I have a Tango Resin, and then I have my glossy Vanilla Banks, who you can't see because she's like behind me where I'm sitting, I think. But yeah, I absolutely adore Sarah Mink's work. So Yeah, this guy is beautiful. I love the mold. The mane, yeah, debatable. I don't think it translated to plastic very well, but otherwise, like, this mold is so cute. I just wish that he didn't have scratches all over his face. Thunder. Now, I am still looking for a glossy Thunder, I think. So, I'm gonna keep him in box, even though I do really like him. And I definitely love the Ashcar mold. I know a lot of people aren't huge fans because of the neck, but I think he's cool, and he's my first on the molds. But I really like him, and I like how pearly this guy is. I think he's a lot nicer than, I think his name's like Sovereign. I'm not gonna try to, I don't know, but the other great horse on the mold. So I'm keeping him in box for now, in hopes that I can get my hands on a glossy one for the right price. But if not, then he's gonna get one of my show string. The last horse I got from that round was Catch Me. I'm super excited about this dude. I owned Ichabod Crane, and I sold him, where did I put my scissors? Oh man, we're gonna take a brief pause. I feel like open, like, you know, like, really like opening a new inbox series from Breyer. Like, I feel like I don't do that very often, just because I don't get a lot of regular runs, but like, what a nice feeling. I mean, I know like everyone has this horse, but he's so cute. The apples are a little fish scaly, but I don't really mind. He is cute. What the heck? I love this horse. I definitely know why like everyone like has him and loves it. Oh, he's pretty flawless. I don't see any rubs. Got a little. Oh, I think that'll come off. Yeah, it's just. It's a little dirty. Rub? Nope. Cool. Yeah. Wow, guys, he's cute. I'm in love with his mold. It's probably my favorite regular run that Breyer has done in a hot second. Oh my god, he is cute. Oh my god, I love him. His little face marking is really cute. It's super crisp. I just think he's so cute. Oh my god. Okay. He's handsome. I love him. Moving on, because we have more ponies to unbox. I originally got Enzo, who was my least favorite, so I was planning on selling him, but then I ended up returning him to Breyer. And so they sent out replacements, and I think everyone who got a replacement got this horse, but I was pleasantly surprised when I opened him because he's one of my favorite variations. So without further ado, I got Glossy Seamus. He's probably one of my favorites. I was wanting Glossy Thunder, but I think Glossy Thunder and him are my favorites. Unpopular opinion, I know. And then probably Glossy Latigo Dunnet, and then Glossy Verdatus, and then Glossy Enzo. But yeah, he looks pretty nice. So yeah, I'm gonna open him. It's definitely a goal of mine. I don't like having multiples, like too many multiples on the same mold, but I do like, but I do want a horse on most every bowls. Oh, he had a little catalog. Cute. Has a little catalog in his box. Remember, always save the bottom of these for your Glossy Collectors Club appreciation models, because that's the only way to like make sure they're legit and gloss bred. Breyer, so my camera died again, and so now it is darker out again, but while I was waiting for my camera to charge, I took the liberty to take this guy out of his box fully, and he's pretty much flawless. I can't really find anything wrong with him. His head's like a little bit smudged masking right there. Like I said, I've always wanted a horse in this mold. I'm not a huge fan of vintage molds, but I do like Chris Hess's work, and this is probably one of my favorite Chris Hess molds, maybe my new favorite. I wanted that Magnus horse, the Dapple Gray, and then also I think it's Walk Down Memory Lane, but obviously I'm not gonna find one of those secondhand that I can afford. So yeah, he is so cute. Sparkings are nice. I love the little bows. I think he's so cute. So yeah, I just think he's really charming. I don't know what I'm gonna call him, but he's definitely sticking with me for the long haul because he's freaking adorable. So yeah, that was everything from the first round of my Collectors Club appreciation. Let's move on to what I got in the second round. So yeah, first thing I got in the second round is just these stalemate pony patches. Because I've collected a lot of stablemates over the past year. I've definitely gotten into collecting them more, and I have a couple stablemate pony pouches that I made, and then I like bubble wrap the rest usually like when I'm going to and from shows, but I feel like it'd be nice to have more of these, so yeah, I'm not gonna unbox that because it's not very exciting. Okay, next, don't judge me. I know unicorns are like, it's pretty the unicorn thing Briar's been doing is like extra, but I saw this guy and he's really cute. And I don't really, the only unicorns I have are stablemates, so I felt like I had to do this. And this is also my first collecta, or whatever they're called now, but yeah. Okay, he's actually packaged so well for such a little bike. Oh my goodness! What in the world? This guy is so cute. Okay, this is interesting. So he's like Collecta, and then he has Briar. So it's just this little Collecta foil. I'm not like the biggest Collecta fan. I'm not a huge fan of the, what is it called? Like the soft plastic rubber models. But the foils, every time they get me. So, not that I have that many. I had like one Schleich foil. Yeah, he's perfect. So cute. He's got glitter in his mane and tail, and I love the color. Like, the blue and the purple is so cute. Honestly, this little guy's adorable, and I have no regrets. Like, I would have never bought him unless I needed to, like, spend the $125, but I don't regret it at all. He's so cute. I can't get over him. So, I know I just said unicorns were extra, and they are. And I got more. So, yeah. Again, I needed to spend money, and I love classic foals. So I got Zoe and Xander. They're so cute, and they're glittery too. So yeah, let's go ahead and open them up. The reason I could not unbox that horse for the life of me, but I finally did. Here we are. This is, I think, Zoe. She is cute. I've never had a horse in this mold. I'm not a huge fan of older classic. I like the, like, classic, full molds, but I like the newer ones usually, but I think she's really cute. I actually think I might like her better than the other guy. Just her color is better, I don't know. But yeah, let's unbox the other one. These two are cute little babies. Honestly though, if I had to pick a favorite, it'd be this one out of all of them. This is the pony for Christmas. I think he like is marketed towards like kids, you know? But from what I've seen, he's a pretty nice model. So, like, this is really nice. Like, this is such nice packaging. This is like, it's Christmas, like 2 months later. But it's marketed towards kids, but I think this is a good idea from Breyer. I really like Wish and Wonder that they did last year though. How freaking adorable. Okay, look at him. Okay, let's get him out of here. Okay, so my camera died for what I think is the third time since I started filming this video, but you know, it's fine. So I just finished unboxing this little Christmas pony, and he's so cute. He has a little blanket. Lastly, I decided to get Paint Me a Pepto. I really wanted Glossy Paint Me a Pepto. I really wanted her last year, but I got Glossy Cody, and I'm really happy with my Glossy Cody, don't get me wrong, but I really wanted Glossy Paint Me a Pepto. But since she's retiring this year, I just decided to buy a matte one. She's gonna be staying in box for the time being, just in case I can get my hands on a glossy one. And also, like, they're selling for quite a bit since they're retired now, so I just decided I'll keep her in box. I adore the Bobby Joe mold. As I said, I adore Morgan Kilborn's sculpts. I think that she does really, really good, like, stock horses and warmblets. This horse is really cool. It does bother me that the real horse is bay and she's black, but nonetheless, super cute model. My local store had like all of the 70th anniversary horses. I actually didn't like the chase piece, I didn't keep him. But I adore the saddlebred, so I kept one of them. This is my second Jennifer Scott sculpt. I have an unpainted Levi resin. She's incredible. Like, she's probably the hobby's most hyped, one of the hobby's most like hyped up sculptors right now, and for good reason. Let's get him unboxed. He's gonna be a huge shelf hog, but a fun space for him. Thing is, like, I really don't like, I don't like the vibe hair mold. I don't like vibe, like, the this pose in general, but something about this horse, like, I adore him and I'm kind of obsessed. My camera died again, but this horse, like, is probably my favorite regular one. Like, he's so beautiful. This sculpt's incredible, so dynamic. He has butt wrinkles. Alrighty, so it is even later, I got myself some food, because my camera died, and I ran out of memory, so I got myself some food, and watched TV, and yeah, just, you know, had a good time, but now I'm back to filming. I guess I forgot to mention that I got a little Darwin. I think he's super cute. I got him in Breyer's Black Friday sale back in November. And yeah, he's my second on the mold. I didn't get Klaus, but I have him, and then I have the 2019 Sinless Stablemate. But yeah, this guy's really cute. I don't know, not much else to say about him. I love the mold, and the pattern is really, really nice. Last but not least, we have my most recent purchase. I actually bought a Carter and then traded my kind of Carter slot for these guys. So this is Rian and Cadell, who are the first releases in the Premier Club of 2019. This is my first time having like Premier Club models, and I have to say I'm pleasantly surprised. These guys are too freaking adorable. Honestly, I prefer the full. He's too cute. This is my new favorite full mold. They're adorable. The person I traded with forgot to ship their COA, but she's sending it in the mail, and the mirror came with this cute little halter on. So yeah, the dapples are beautiful, the color is amazing. This mold is really nice. It's super cute and small. All right, if you made it this far in the video, congratulations. You made it. Thank you for listening to me talk for so long, and I'll see you guys in the next video.